Hallo.
Hallo.
This is Herre.
This is Terrier. We are here.
Yeah, and
apparently.
We're going to make some comments to the new album, Valkyria.
Yes. This is the first song from the album, which me and Herre wrote.
I think you wrote the riff in a bigger song.
It's
that you sent to me.
The main riff is a long time I wrote it.
Yeah.
And now it got picked up by Harry, and then he arranged the song around it, basically.
It was going to be the third song on the album, if I remember correctly, but we moved it up quite late in the recording process.
Actually, our manager, David Karakandas, wanted to move it up to the first song.
Yes, David Karakandas.
Yeah. That guy.
Yeah, because I think he thought it was the most catchy song, which it probably is.
Yeah. Well, what do you think?
Do you think it's the most catchy song? Write us and let us know.
So what are the lyrics about here?
Well, it's sort of a nationalistic text about the niceties of living in a nice place of the world and what one might do to protect it and preserve it. War in this case, of course, since we're a Viking metal band.
So Faroe Islands.
Yes, could be anywhere in Scandinavia, but let's say it's Faroe Islands. No, it can't be, because the guy walks somewhere to a battlefield and that couldn't be here. If you walk too long in the Faroes, you end up in the ocean.
You end up in a battlefield if you're out partying with me.
Which is why I never do that. Cheers.
Yeah. Oh, good morning. So when's the solo coming?
After the second chorus.
Uh-huh.
So, it's
where
same...
was this going to be on? Spotify, I think, I heard.
I don't remember. They just told us to make comments. I don't know what they're going to use it for. If you listen to this, please write to me and tell me where you heard it.
Thank you.
Here goes the solo.
Oh
yeah, and suddenly there are three guitar players into it.
Yeah, no. Yes, no four. Maybe five, because now
you're playing there.
But it's all manageable with one good guitar player.
Yes, and one bad.
No, with two good floorboards, then everything is possible.
Exactly. It's pretty much the same theme throughout the whole song, just one riff made into the variations. I think I remember now the chorus was supposed to be half length and only have this different lyrics that you hear right now in the end, but Jacob thought we should make the chorus, the vocals in the chorus longer.
Yeah, I remember something about that also.
So that's why it ends so suddenly right now. Works fine though.
Yeah.
The song is called Mayor of My Night. It was gonna be the first song on the album.
Yeah, this was gonna be the first one on the album.
But I think it works fine with the other one, and second is fine too.
But every time when I hear the album now, I think I put the album on wrong, because I think this is the first song.
Yeah, we had this for the first song on the...
For a while.
On the demos for a while, yeah. I wrote this song quite some time ago. I think I had it already when we made the last album, and I made at least 20 different variations over the theme. It's again the same theme throughout the whole song. And
yeah, I remember I was at your place and you showed me the song for the first time. It was a mess.
Yes, I always make it a mess. I just take one theme and then make variations and more variations over that, and then pick out the best ones for verse and chorus and interlude and whatever. Then I just picked out these ones. I think it's early variations.
It worked out good, I think.
Worked out okay.
Very good.
Lyrically, Well, see, a guy or a man found a woman he first thought was a goddess. Turns out she's a nightmare. That never happened to me. That's not what I wrote it, but just imagine that happened. That's what this song's about.
Well, let's keep it at that.
So, it's built over the folklore about the mare, the woman, or the creature that supposedly rides you when you have are having a nightmare. It's this dark creature that lays on top of you and counts your teeth, and if it manages to count all your teeth before you wake up, you will not... you will die within the year. That's the folklore, at least. And I couldn't help but noticing some, shall I say, sexual undertones to the mythology. So I just took it to an extreme, and this the lyrics are quite naughty in some places.
Good boy. And now we have around 5-6 guitar players again. Seven?
I can only hear two.
So you don't hear the rhythm guitars?
Yes, but there's just one rhythm
line. Lead.
Yeah, you'll
yeah, this solo was a nightmare to nail.
You'll fix it with your floorboard.
Yeah. I just remember that solo was a nightmare to get in the
probably
closet.
Because of the chord progression.
Yeah, a lot of chord progressions and stuff. But it turned out all right.
At the end, especially with the band.
Oh yeah, Harry made up one tone for me.
Two.
Thank you so much.
Well, four if you count the harmony.
Actually, it is mixed later by Jacob Hansen, so it's not exactly it. It comes in as an effect, you know?
Whatever.
Yeah.
No, not much more to say about that.
Not much more, I think. Well, this riff was a pain in the ass to play because it was the first time I played it when I recorded it.
It sounds like my vocals.
Yeah.
It's the first time I've seen the text is when I sing it. Hell Hath No Fury. Third song. Well, the name is obviously stolen from the quote Hell Hath No Fury Like a Woman Scorned, which is, I forget which writer that is, but it was an English writer a few hundred years ago who wrote the lines. Heaven holds no rage like love to hate returned, nor hell a fury like a woman scorned. I stole that. Unashamedly, I put it in this song because I thought it sounded cool, especially writing hell with one L and making it more pagan in a way. Lyrically, well, the guy decides to call it quit and leave his home and his woman, and not much more to say about that. Maybe there is, I can't think of it right now.
Well, I remember singing the choirs to this song. That was a nightmare because of the tones and vocals are going up and down, especially the second voices and stuff.
Yeah,
so that took a few tries to nail that.
It's always a bit like that, but probably worse in this case because the melody is switches between goes from harmonic minor to Dorian, and then
here we go
to,
again.
From D Dorian and to A harmonic minor and back to D common minor.
So you see where we had the problem,
so,
right?
There's a lot of, but it's not that uncommon melodic progression, not for me at least. It sounds very folky and Faroese, I think. So I've used it a few times already.
Well, when four guys have to sing it at once.
You should get used to it. We made it okay. Yeah. Took maybe a few hours.
Yeah, maybe.
You see what I have to deal with? Bitches.
Ah, yeah, bitches.
Yeah.
Here's another solo that was a bit of a nightmare. I don't know why.
probably the same reason.
I couldn't nail it. But it turned out good. It takes a few hours when you're not prepared and go to the studio without anything written before. Like
we were quite unprepared this time. I think worse than ever.
Yeah.
And then you sit and you...
Just right from court.
Yeah, so there's not much time to prepare.
Completely
either.
Burned out.
Some of us.
Most of us.
Anyway, you sit there and then you just have to improvise or think up a solo on the spot, and it's sort of hit and miss. Sometimes it's okay, sometimes it's not. And if you were at home, you'd delete it and remake it the next day. But there's not always time for that in studio. So sometimes you have to keep something that's not as good as you want to.
And when you get home to hear it afterwards, you think, why the hell didn't I change that part?
Yeah.
The Lay of Our Love.
Yes, this one is with Liv Christine from Liv's Eyes.
Yes. I think she asked me once if she could sing guest vocals on our album. I don't remember precisely. I think that's what she did. And I asked the guys, and we said it was a good idea. I think we thought about already in advance to ask someone to sing guest vocals. Not necessarily female.
Not necessarily female, but then here they told us, or you told us about it. And I agreed about it, but Gunnar, our bass player, he didn't.
Well, he never agrees about anything.
No,
I would be surprised if he
agreed.
That's
another thing.
Yeah.
But he came around.
Yeah, so
and
fuck
said
you,
yes.
Gunnar. This is great.
he's a doll.
Yes, he's a darling, really. So, of course, she plays the part of the woman that the guy is leaving here. This is more of the sentimental or romantic side of it. The lyrics are pretty straightforward. The melody is a Faroese Danish folk melody that I heard from a guy that lived in my neighborhood. He's dead now, and I've wanted to use it for a long time, but I never really found a place to put it. And then I remember I was working on it, and it had some odd timings that made it difficult to work with. So I just put a few notes in here and there to avoid the odd timings, so I could use it for a more common sounding song like this one. And if I have to say so myself, it turned out brilliantly.
Now the Scorpion solo.
It's a great solo.
Yeah, well, Gunnar, our bassist, he was by my side during this, because he wanted a solo that the pants would fall off the girls, basically. Well, at least his pants fell off.
And his job is done, at least.
And I remember, in this part, I made some, Jacob Hansen, the producer, he told me to play something over this. And I probably misunderstood him and continued with some sort of solo, and it sounded like a mess to me also.
Yeah.
Like here it is. Thank God it got deleted before.
Yeah, that's all again, unpreparedness. If one had been prepared in advance, you could have done something, easily done something proper with it. So guys, you get a second-rate product because of our unpreparedness.
No, it's not second-rate. It's mixed well.
Yeah, we fixed it in the mix. Screaming at the top of my lungs again.
Now looking forward to that live.
Yeah, it'll be easy. We'll put it on backtrack.
Yeah.
Or I'll have an octaver on my vocals. Nation, Icelandic melody and lyrics. I got a CD from a guy. Actually, the song is dedicated to him. He died of cancer some time ago, a guy in Iceland called Ingólfur Júlíusson. He gave me a CD what's called?
By the way, he made our first video also.
Yeah, he made our first three videos, actually.
Three videos.
Hail to the Hammer and the Rengismir also.
That's good.
He gave me this CD with quite a man of Félagið Idun from Icelandic Ballad Singer Society release. It's got about 100 ballads, Icelandic traditional ballads on it, and one of them was Brennivín on the Land album actually. This the chorus in this one is another one. And with the lyrics, the traditional lyrics at least, say it's sort of a nationalistic, what can I call it? It's about folklore, that folklore, the dreams of a people are preserved in folklore. And the song is written more in a way to the Icelandic people and on their way out of the financial recession. Maybe a bit the same as the first song, Blood of Heroes, you know, about what's nice about your homeland and what's worth to preserve with it. Yeah, the riff is sort of made over the first part of the melody. It's very heavy, maybe a bit Hamanamark sounding.
Remember this riff? I had to put these squeals on with the guitar because it sounded too flat otherwise.
Yeah.
But I know some YouTubers will complain about that.
Ah, who cares?
Yeah, fuck you. I'm not trying to be Zach Wilde.
Here goes Icelandic. It's actually with a heavy Faroese accent. An Icelandic person might think it's not Icelandic at first listen, but it's a mess to pronounce, especially for my bandmates maybe, since they don't speak Icelandic. So I just put it half in Faroese, or like we do with Danish all the time, we pronounce it with a heavy Faroese accent and just did the same to Icelandic here, although that's not very common to hear spoken.
No. Oh, the solo.
Yeah, say something about this.
Well, I think we struggled with them all because we didn't have that much time.
Yeah. Just here goes my part.
Yeah.
Could have been
turned out pretty good, I think.
Yeah, just following the rhythm guitar, cheap trick.
Thing is, when you have to record all the rhythm guitars and then make solos after that, you're completely burned out. You don't know what to do.
Yes.
Everything sounds the same.
Exactly. When you've been listening to mixes for 8 hours a day, it's very hard to concentrate on what's actually going on.
I hope our solos will be accepted.
So your judgment isn't tip-top.
No. You don't hear it before you get home.
Yeah, exactly.
A month after or something.
And then it's too late.
Yep. But next time.
Next time. I swear, next time. Like I did the last three times.
Yeah. Same here.
George did okay, at least, on short notice.
Oh yeah,
better than we did. Yeah.
I think now we would go.
Another Fallen Brother, Terje.
Yeah, this is a song I wrote a long time ago. Actually, more than 2 years ago, I think I wrote it.
Yeah.
And it was supposed to be a song for my solo project, but ended up on this album.
Yes.
It was not meant to be, but we needed more songs on the album, and
So we stole some of Terje's ideas. I love the melody in the chorus, the guitar melody that was there.
Yeah.
So
it's more fast song than we usually play, and as you can hear, George, he is flipping out on the drums.
Yeah.
Well, this is maybe soft for him, but
I think this is slow for him. Yes.
For us.
Faster than we were played, I guess.
Yes, exactly. And a lot of guitar playing.
Yeah.
Going on. What's the song about here?
The guy has reached the guy has reached the battlefield and has clear plans to die in battle, bravely enough that the Valkyrie may take him to to try out to Folkvanger, and that's pretty much what's going on here.
Yeah, and I remember you changed the rhythm part in the words here a bit.
Did I change the vocal melody, you're saying?
No, the rhythm guitar.
The rhythm guitar.
A little bit.
Yeah, I just moved the harmonies around so it fitted to the key.
The singing.
And I put some extra harmonies on, didn't I?
Not extra harmonies, but you moved some notes around.
Yeah, yes. I think it was the first verse I put the harmony on. It's a lot simpler, I think, to begin with.
I can't remember.
I can't either.
Never mind. Yeah, here comes a part that usually isn't here.
Yeah, this
you can hear from George.
Yeah.
And another solo. Well, this one was quite easy because
you've probably done that a long time in advance.
Yeah.
Wasn't this a lot longer to begin with?
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
I can't remember. I forget everything.
Yeah.
But I don't think it was longer because it's long enough as it is now. I think.
Yes, I guess it is.
Is it fast enough?
No. Yes. More stealing this time from Shakespeare, Cry Havoc, and Let Slip the Dogs of War, or whatever he says. Well, the lyrics, as everything, was done on last minute notice, so I was stealing without any conscience from everywhere I could steal ideas from, and I'm not ashamed to admit that even. I did that also for this song. I think at least I haven't heard the phrase "another fallen brother" before. So much I think I can say.
Once or twice. And I just remember you sitting up until 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning every day writing lyrics. Grindavísan.
Yes.
Like Grindavísan from Jakobsen.
Grindavísan. Yeah. The Grind newspaper.
Yeah.
So this
go ahead, weekends.
A Faroese Danish traditional. It's about the pilot whale hunt. It was written in 17 something by a Danish amtmann. What is that? The caretaker of the throne in the Faroes or something. And he was quite pro. No one was anti any sort of harvest of wildlife in those days. So this was quite uncontroversial until a few 10 years ago. But this is dedicated to Paul Watson, actually, on the album.
Yeah.
The sleeve bag.
Fuck yourself,
yeah,
by the way.
Coward.
Yeah,
Skip Bale in Germany a few months ago, or more than that. Anyway, there's not. It's a very long ballad. The original one has maybe 80 or 100 verses. It's not that, as poetry goes at least, it's not that well written. So I just picked out the most lyrical verses and to put them in. Also, not all verses are very well written to sing rhythmically, so I also consider that when I pick them out. So there's no storyline as such in the song because it's way too short for that. Ooh. And the chorus says, industrious lads to kill pilot whale, that's what we like.
And we like it.
And we like it. Oh, listen, I love what George did here.
Yes.
The nice filling.
He's an amazing drummer.
He does this, you know, first take.
Yeah, first take.
He just thinks about what to do for a few rounds, and then he says record, and he plays like this. It's fantastic.
Yeah, then he came out, listen, and then he went in and made some minor changes.
Yeah.
Not like he just did some little fills, re-recorded, but he recorded a whole piece over again.
Yes.
So he's not.
Not like we do. When we make a mistake, we correct only the mistake and nothing else.
Don't say that.
Can you delete it? Anyway, the whole song has two themes, and that's the chorus and the verse, and everything goes over those two themes. And the melody that came right before this part, I think, it sounds very cryptical when you listen to it, but it makes sense when put together with the melody you're hearing right now.
We were actually talking about to get King Diamond to sing on this song, but
yeah,
we never got that far.
We asked our Brian at the label at least,
no,
to ask. Or I think we only talked to David, the manager, about
no,
it.
We only talked to David. Yeah.
I'm not sure he went further with it, or if King Diamond was busy. But
since it is a Danish,
exactly, he's Danish, so he could have sung the Danish parts. Yeah, that was the original idea. I'm not sure what he thinks about Greenpeace and Sea Shepherd.
No, that's the thing.
Yeah, so he might have disagreed with us on this.
Maybe he's a vegan also. But I hope not.
I hope not.
And there it is. A sad ending.
Only four guys singing that is amazing.
Yeah, that's unbelievable.
Into the Sky. This song was done, I think, first of all songs on the album. It was finished, I think, around the time the last album was made. And I remember I came up with the original idea for the verse at least 5 years ago in the rehearsal room in Saltangara. Kari and I were there. And I just slowly worked on it for a long time. We actually wanted to enter the Eurovision contest with this one. But we were too late. I think half a day too late.
You mean you wanted to enter that contest?
I asked you all and no one disagreed except Gunnar, but no one listened to him in this band.
No, that's true.
We wouldn't want to do that for publicity. So that's the reason this song is less than 3 minutes long and the last chorus is 1.5 step higher.
Yeah, and no solo.
And no solo. There's not time for a solo.
What the hell is that about?
So here, the guy has fallen on the battlefield and very proud with himself that he made the Valkyrie come for him.
Ooh, that sounds naughty.
Yes, it sort of is. It's a very naughty album altogether.
Yes, read the lyrics.
Yes. This is also a traditional melody that has sort of changed a bit or a lot. A very traditional. I was recording the demo for this in Copenhagen. In a rehearsal room, and Gunnar was there, said that the melody line in the chorus should go upwards on the second phrase instead of down. And so I tried it, it sounded great, but it got really high to sing, so I knew we had to do something about it. I wanted to change the melody a bit again, but turned out a much faster solution was to play it lower, but it was already down in B on our 7-string guitars. So we just did it in drop A, I think you call it.
Yeah, I remember when I recorded it. Usually when we record, we write everything down on Guitar Pro. And I didn't look closely enough that it had to be drop A. And I was playing this chord, and it sounded fucking terrible.
Yeah.
I had to ask Jacob, the producer, to come in. Does this sound right? And he just said, what the hell has he done there?
Nothing surprising.
Then we recorded it, and then what? Yeah, this is not good. Then I went to ask Harry, and then he told me that was drop A. Then it sounded all right after that.
Yeah, but you don't. I don't think you can hear it. I don't think of it, at least when I hear the song, that it sounds deeper than usual.
Definitely not. I don't hear it. So I didn't even hear it when I dropped it down.
No. So I guess we're used to the low end by now.
Yeah.
Fannar Borstur Brandaljo, Ferry's text in the song, it means fades the sound of swords. It's not common language, I'd like to write in a very archaic sounding.
But here you actually play guitar on the album.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I played the, well, I was writing lyrics all the time, so I asked Terje to record all the
leads
and the rhythm guitars.
This is the first time you came in and recorded this lead piece.
Yeah. Why was that? Does it go above 24 frets? I don't remember. Maybe I just wanted some time off from writing lyrics.
No, I think the...
Where the hell was that?
I can't remember, but there was something. It probably has... Because here he has a 29, 30... How many do we have?
30.
30 frets guitar.
Yeah,
I only have 24.
There's an octave on the melody there. I think it goes about 24. Yeah,
probably.
Yeah. Anyhow, it's a Norwegian traditional melody. I heard it first with Morten Harket, the singer of A-ha, found on YouTube. someone, a fan, was it in the Netherlands, showed it to me or sent it to me on Facebook. And I thought it was a great melody. I wanted to use it. That's many, many years ago already. And didn't get around to it until now. So I made a chord progression for it and a harmonic vocal line. It has some odd timings as well. Sorry. I think George mentioned that it was quite difficult for him. Well, not difficult, relatively difficult for him to play the odd times.
I think I got used to those odd timings there. Because I think I nailed those parts in one.
Yeah.
Oddly enough.
Yes.
Maybe Gunnar was behind me, I don't know. He's my guardian angel.
So these parts
again.
Yeah, here I go. That's my part there, just doodling away. It could be more melodic. I'd probably do that if I could do it again.
But that one is kind of melodic.
Yeah, the end of it.
You mean the middle part?
The middle part, right. We hadn't gotten to the end when I said that. It's a very heavy rhythm in the verse. I like that. Very heavy drums and guitar.
Yeah, I don't know why George said it was difficult for him, because he did it in one take, I think.
Yeah. But maybe he just has to think more than usual.
Maybe.
So this part is not traditional. Only the vocal part is the traditional one. And this I just came up with doodling and thinking what would be fitting for the rest of the melody. And this wasn't supposed to be this fast.
No.
I think on the demo I made, it's half tempo of the kick there. Yeah. He made it very good. Yeah. Thank you, George.
Yeah, thank you.
Lady of the Slain.
Lady of the Slain.
Terje.
That's another song written by me. Maybe not the usual tier either. That one was also written a long time ago when I used to live in Germany, in Berlin. This maybe is more like thrash metal, what you say? I don't know. This part at least. And fast.
Very fast, yes. Or faster
George,
than we usually play.
George seems to enjoy himself again.
Yeah. I remember I also liked the melody and the chorus quite a lot.
Yeah. Horse rhythm again.
Yeah.
Gunnar usually writes those, but I had to get a part of that. I've actually... Yeah, he asked me to write lyrics for this song. And I wrote the first lyrics in my life.
I hope you wouldn't mention that. I read half of it and I couldn't stop crying with laughter. So, so I deleted it.
I hope you deleted it from your computer.
And first I put it on YouTube.
Oh, okay. It was terrible. It sounded like a 12-year-old writing a lyric.
I know 12-year-olds who write much better than that.
Okay.
Anyway, it was very fun.
Hey, I just came off tour.
It was last minute as usual, and And I was seriously worried I wouldn't make the lyrics in time. So we decided to let Gunnar and Terje have a try. I think David's idea.
Yeah, and I sent my lyrics to our manager, and he usually answers pretty fast, but he didn't answer at all, so that's pretty bad.
So anyway, these lyrics, well, the guy has reached Falkvanger and Freya's home now, and is quite impressed with lifestyle, so it's sort of the ultimate heathen heaven. It's more or less just about Freya and all the attributes she has as a goddess. Tears of Red Gold and everything.
It was supposed to be called Tears of Red Gold in the beginning of the song. Wasn't it?
Yeah.
The title.
Yeah. It was. But then we changed it to Lady of the Slain. I'm not sure why. It sounds cooler. I don't know either.
I can't remember.
I had a reason back then.
Probably David Karakantas.
He may be. Most likely.
And here comes a part that's not usual to it at all.
Well, the solo is quite usual to you, at least.
Not this part.
Yes, it is.
No, maybe this time comes now. No, not all. Is it? Well, this part was supposed to be faster, I mean, drum-wise, but George, he slowed it down to a half tempo. And I thought that was much cooler.
Yeah.
Maybe he knows what he's doing.
I think it does. It's very good to get an extreme drummer's take on everything.
Yeah.
And he has a very good taste as for what to put in and what to change, I think. He improved.
He doesn't overdo it.
No.
Not at all. Well, actually, we wanted him to overdo some stuff, but he said no to that.
Yeah, it was a wise choice.
Probably a wise choice. And here we had to change some notes. And
here we go. The chorus for the last time. We put an extra guitar on it and just took it from the melody part, and yeah, it didn't fit properly, so changed it a bit.
Ooh.
Valkyria, title track.
This one's written by our bassist. God rest his soul.
He sent me the original riff. So I made variations, as usual, that's all I do, actually. I made variations over it and picked out one for the verse and one for chorus and this one for the beginning. Jacob told me it sounds a bit like Greek traditional, you know, sorbas, and I thought it was a nice gesture to George to put some sorbas on the album. Though I think this first part turned out quite well. I mean, like everything, this solo or the doodling I do here was done in the last minute. So for last minute, I'm at least satisfied with it.
This is the more epic song of the album.
Here we go. If you listen to the melody here, that's what Gunnar sent me. Cheers.
Ah, cheers.
I don't think that was a chord progression. He played the whole thing in Edorian. So I put it through Edorian and melodic and harmonic E minor, and put the chord progression to it as well, and made tons of variations over it. Terry was complaining, I remember, when he was playing the rhythm guitar in the verse. Never make so many variations again.
Yeah, because there are variations from verse to verse. Yes. And I was looking at the notes like, why?
I thought it's a very long song. Yeah, it's very long. You can't hear it, but I think you can feel it somehow. It's a very long song, and it got very monotonous.
Yes, trust me, I felt it, yes.
This was, of course, the last text I wrote, since it's the last song I recorded. Also, no, actually, this was not the last song. We have two bonus tracks that we're not going to make comments to here. So this was the third last song I recorded. And so the last lyric I wrote, of course, since I don't write the lyrics for the bonus tracks, they're covers. And it was ridiculous, actually. I mean, I was sitting every evening up until 5 in the morning, filling my face with candy and sweets so as not to fall asleep.
Yeah, I remember waking up at 4 or 5 or something because I wanted to pee, and it was still sitting up. You were still sitting up.
Yeah.
Writing lyrics.
Which I will never, ever, ever do again, David.
Oh,
never.
That's it. Yeah, David, do you listen?
It turned out decent. I would do it differently if I had better time. I think I would. Lost like a raven in the night. What the hell does that mean?
I think that's the best thing you ever wrote. What are you talking about?
So lyrically, the guy is contemplating his destiny, and he's quite satisfied with where he ended up and how things went. Although it's quite a nostalgic lyrics. It sounds very dark to begin with, but in the chorus, the guy says, "All my dreams have come to pass," which is the basic message of the song. So, yeah, here we go. Second verse.
Yeah, I really like the verse, the guitar part here, at least.
It's very heavy.
It's very, how do you say, easy on the hands to play.
Yeah.
It's very, yeah. It's like bother to play that part. I think, at least. Maybe someone else will think it's some pain in the ass that hasn't been in tear for just many years.
Get used to everything.
Yeah.
Yeah, now you hear in the lyrics how desperate I was. Just quoting sayings. I try to make it fit in at least, but I don't know.
It fits in good. Most people don't listen to the lyrics anyway, so.
Oh!
As long as it sounds good, then it's.
The hell am I wasting my time with that?
I never understood it.
It's the same theme throughout the song, of course, same chord progression here. Just some more. What do you call it, power metal guitars compared to the verse. Works fine, just change the melody a bit.
Well, the rhythm guitars are actually quite soft over this part, but
yeah,
it is more power metal in a way.
This choir here, Valkyrian, I put in last minute. I didn't plan it, actually. I was done recording the vocals for this song and I thought it needs something extra. I mean, the title of the song wasn't even in there, so I just made up this line.
It's gonna be fun to sing live.
Watch it, yeah. And now I think at least it's sort of the centerpiece of the song, and it's strange how accidentally how things turn out, that you just think of something here and now, and this at least worked quite well. And that's not always the case with the solos, for example. And we'll put some chorus on that. That's going to be fun to try and imitate live. But we make do.
Yeah. Some tapping going on. I think this will be a good live song.
Yes, something like The Lay of Thrym or something.
Yeah, definitely. To play last, I think.
Yeah.
I hate this word, but epic. But whatever.
That's what it is.
Something like that. What is actually epic here, do you know?
Pompous and... Well, how the hell do you explain that?
Exactly.
Pompous and long, big, whatever. Look it up in the dictionary.
No, I don't own a dictionary.
Online.
And I don't have internet. I don't have a laptop, so forget about it.
You're starting to sound like Gunnar.
At least affecting me. And this part is gonna be fun live.
Thank you and good night.
Yes, here ends this narrative.